So let us now understand mechanical here simple harmonic oscillator, that is the spring mass system which is vertically loaded. So let us draw it. So when the load is applied, the spring got displaced by the distance L, and hence the restoring force which will act opposite to the displacement is minus KL. Now suppose additionally we have extended the spring to y distance, that is L plus y, then the restoring force in the direction opposite to the displacement, it will be equal to minus K L plus Y, minus K L plus Y. Again repeating, the spring is fixed to the rigid support and at the free end the mass is loaded. When the load is applied, the downward force which is acting is M into G, and the due to the downward displacement, the restoring force acts on the spring, which will be equal to minus KL, spring constant and the displacement, and negative sign suggests that the displacement and the restoring force are oppositely directed, as we have seen in the characteristics of simple harmonic motion. And when the spring is further extended, then again the downward force, it will be equal to mg, but then the restoring force, it will be equal to minus k into l plus y. Okay. So if we take condition 2, that is the spring when it is loaded with the mass, the restoring force is KL, and negative sign suggests that the displacement and the restoring force is oppositely directed, and minus KL is equal to 0, or mg is equal to KL, or we can write K is equal to mg by L, and it is known, already known, K is spring constant. We can write it as force constant, or we can write it as stiffness constant as well. M is the mass of the load, and g is acceleration due to gravity. And L is the displacement, amplitude of displacement. L is the amplitude of displacement. So this is for the first condition. Let us take it as equation 1. At equilibrium, mg is equal to minus kl. So mg will be equal to kl, or k is equal to mg by l. Now let us go to for the third condition. When the spring is further extended and the displacement is, so if we assume that the spring balances the tension T, then for the second condition, what we can write, T is equal to mg, and that is equal to kl. The negative sign here just represents that the displacement and the restoring forces oppositely directed. So what is the tension in the spring? It will be equal to mg, and that is equal to kl at equilibrium. Now if we take the condition 3, means when the load is applied and the spring is further extended to displacement y, that is L plus y, and the balancing force is kl plus y, then we assume that the tension in the spring is T dash. So at equilibrium, taking condition 3, this was taking condition 2, we can write it that the total restoring force acting on the spring F, that is equal to T minus T dash. So T is equal to KL, and T dash, if we resolve this, then it will be equal to minus KL plus Y. So KL plus Y, the negative sign there suggests that the displacement and the restoring force is oppositely directed, and so the total restoring force acting on the spring, this is condition 2, it is T, and in the condition 3 it is T dash, so it will be equal to T minus T dash. Substituting the value of the tension which is balanced by the spring, it is equal to KL, and T dash is equal to KL plus Y. Further solving this, what we get, F is equal to minus KY, that is the total restoring force or the acceleration is proportional to the displacement and is oppositely directed. So this mechanical simple harmonic oscillator or the spring mass system, we can say that it is the condition for, means it is an example for the simple harmonic motion. A body spring mass system which is executing vertically can be represented by simple harmonic motion. So let us consider this as equation 2. Now what we know, if we want to write the differential equation for this kind of oscillation, means mechanical simple harmonic oscillator, will proceed as usual. As per Newton's second law, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration we define by double differential of the displacement, and that is equal to minus ky. So we can write it m d2y by dt square plus ky is equal to 0. And if we divide it by m, this equation, what we get? D2y by dt square plus k by m into y is equal to 0, or d2y by dt square plus omega square y is equal to 0. So we have arrived to the previous equation, means the differential equation of SHM. So spring mass system is an also can be said as an example of simple harmonic motion, means a body executing, a system executing simple harmonic motion. So here omega square is equal to k by m, or omega is equal to square root of k by m. What we know, omega is the angular frequency. So let us now derive the expression for frequency and the time period for the simple harmonic oscillators. So let us now derive the expression for time period and the frequency of the system executing simple harmonic motion. So as usual, I will start what we derived. What is the equation for simple harmonic motion? Y is equal to A sin omega t plus phi, where A is the amplitude, omega is the angular frequency, and phi is the initial phase. So if we consider omega as the angular frequency, with the linear frequency we relate it by equation, omega is 2 pi nu. Nu is the frequency of oscillation. What we understand, omega is equal to square root of k by m, or simply we can write it as omega square is equal to k by m. Then from equation 2 and 3, what we'll do, we'll substitute the value of omega. We get from 2 and 3, equation 2 and 3, 2 pi nu whole square is equal to k by m, or 4 pi square nu square is equal to k by m. And when we solve it, we get nu is equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of k by m. You can take 4 pi square to the denominator, you will get nu square is equal to 1 by 4 pi square k by m. And when you take nu value, you have to do square root. So what we will get? Nu is equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of k by m. Now what we know, that time period is reciprocal of the frequency. So the time period equation can be written as reciprocal of the frequency, that is 2 pi square root of m divided by. So equation 4 represents the frequency of oscillation And equation 5 represents the time period of oscillation. Okay, so this is when we started with the angular frequency equation, we have arrived for the frequency and the time period expression. Now if we take the differential equation and then if we try to derive the relation for frequency, means expression for frequency and time period, let us see what we will get. So the differential equation of SHM, we know it is given by d2y by dt square plus omega square y is equal to 0. d2y by dt square represents the acceleration plus omega square and y represents the displacement. That will be equal to 0. Acceleration will be equal to minus omega square into the displacement. Now if we ignore the negative sign, what we can write? Omega square is equal to acceleration, take to the denominator the displacement, acceleration divide by displacement. So omega can be written as square root of acceleration by displacement, or we know omega is equal to 2 pi nu. So this will be equal to acceleration by displacement. So the frequency, omega is the angular frequency, nu is the linear frequency of the oscillation. It will be equal to 1 by 2 pi acceleration by displacement. And we know that time period is reciprocal of the frequency. So time period can be written as 2 pi square root of displacement by acceleration. So depending on the problem given, you can solve for the frequency and the time period. And also the time period, if you have arrived, you know the frequency value, just take the reciprocal of it to get the time period. So we'll see all this during our problem solving session. Now let us go further with the system when the springs are connected in series and in parallel. So what will be the force constant? Expression for force constant when the springs are connected in series and in parallel. So let us derive the expression for the equivalent spring constant, which you call it as force constant or stiffness constant as well, in the case when spring is connected in series and spring is connected in parallel. So let us take the case for first the springs connected in series. So let us take the two springs S1 and S2. S1 has a spring constant of K1 and S2 has a spring constant of K2. So now when you load the spring with the mass,
the spring undergoes extension, and let the extension in the spring 1, it is y1, and the spring 2 means s2, it is y2. So the overall extension from the mean position, it will be equal to y, and that will be equal to y1 plus y2, means the extension in spring s1 plus extension in spring s2. So we have considered two springs. S1 and S2. Spring S1 has spring constant of K1. S2 has spring constant K2. And application of load. Application of load M causes an extension in the spring, and we assume that the spring S1 undergoes the extension Y1 and spring S2 undergoes extension Y2. So therefore the overall extension due to the load applied, y will be equal to y1 plus y2. Means the sum of the extension produced in the spring 1 and the spring 2, that is equal to y. Now at equilibrium, what we can say, the downward force must be equal to the upward force. Here the negative sign only suggests that the restoring force is directed opposite to the displacement, that is extension produced. So at equilibrium for spring S1, what we can write, mg is equal to k1 y1 and for s2 we can write it as mg is equal to k2 y2. So from this expression we can write y1 is equal to mg divide by k1, and if we consider the equation, this equation, we can write y2 is equal to mg divided by k2. Y1 is equal to mg divided by k1, take it to the denominator, and y2 is equal to mg divided by k2, swap the equation, you will get y1 is equal to mg by k1 and y2 is equal to mg by k2. So let us write it as equation 2 and equation 3. Now suppose we consider the overall system, means combination of spring 1 and 2 as one spring, and say that the overall system has the spring constant is equal to k equal. Overall spring constant of the system, we write it as K equivalent, and if we consider that the load is applied, Then at equilibrium, what we can write? Mg is equal to K equivalent into Y. The overall extension, if we consider both spring, if it is connected in series and combination of connection makes it one single entity, then the overall displacement is Y. The single entity means overall system, the spring combination makes the spring constant K equivalent, and Mg is the downward force, where M is the mass of the load applied and G is acceleration due to gravity. So from this equation, what we can write? Y is equal to Mg by K equal. Now let us substitute equation 2, Y1 is equal to Mg by K1. Equation 3, Y2 is equal to Mg by K2, and equation 4, Y is equal to Mg by K equivalent in equation 1, means Y is equal to Y1 plus Y2. You can take this Mg as common, so it will be Mg in bracket 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2. So Mg, Mg in both the sides, it will be cancelled out, and you will get 1 by K equivalent is equal to 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2. So equation 5 is the expression for the equivalent spring constant. When we took two springs having spring constant K1 and K2. Now if you suppose you are connecting n numbers of spring or more than that, then the K equivalent expression for the equivalent spring constant, you can write it as 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2 so on plus 1 by Kn plus so on till the number is given. So what will be the time period and the frequency of the oscillation if the springs are connected in series? So we know the frequency of oscillation is given by 1 by 2 pi square root of K by M. So in the case of series, first we have to calculate the equivalent spring constant and substitute the value to get the frequency of oscillation. So mu will be equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of K equivalent by M, and time period 2 pi square root of M by K equivalent. So we'll see in the problem, first we have to calculate the equivalent spring constant and then substitute the value to get the frequency and the time. making the two combinations. Now we have to understand it here, when the mass is loaded on the spring, then both the spring, in the case of series we saw that spring 1 underwent the extension of pi 1 and spring 2 went the extension of pi 2. But here both the spring, it will undergo the extension, that is equal to pi. So this restoring force which is acting on the spring S1 is minus K1 into Y, and the restoring force which is acting on spring S2 is equal to minus K2 Y, and the downward force is Mg. So we have considered two springs. S1 and S2 having the force constant or the spring constant K1 and K2, and when the load is applied, it means the load is applied, the spring both S1 and S2 undergoes an extension equal to. We also consider the combination equivalent spring constant is equal to K equivalent. So now if we try to derive the total restoring force, when the spring is in combination of S1 and S2, then Mg will be equal to K equivalent into Y. Again, due to only S1, due to S1, Mg will be equal to K1 into Y, and due to S2, Mg will be equal to K2 into Y.
So we have derived the total restoring force due to the combination, which is Mg into K equivalent into Y. Due to S1, Mg is equal to K1 into Y, and due to S2, Mg is equal to K2 into Y. Now what we know at equilibrium, the total restoring force, it will be equal to the restoring force due to spring S1 and restoring force due to spring S2. So at equilibrium, the total restoring force, I denote restoring force by RFF, the total restoring force, it will be equal to restoring force due to S1 plus restoring force due to S2. So if we substitute the value in the equation, we get the total restoring force Mg is equal to here K equivalent into Y, and K1 it is for spring S1, K1 into Y, and for spring S2 it is K2, it is K2 into Y. So further we can solve it, K equivalent into Y will be equal to k1 plus k2, y is common in both, and now yy cancels out, so k equivalent will be equal to k1 plus k2. So if we write it as equation 4, or you can take it as starting from series, you can take 1, 2, 3, 4 and continue it. So k equivalent is equal to k1 plus k2, means equivalent spring constant is the sum of the spring constant due to the individual springs. But in the case of spring in series, the reciprocal of equivalent spring constant is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of the spring constant of the individual springs. Now suppose if we have n number of springs, then k equivalent will be equal to k1 plus k2 plus so on plus kn. If we have infinite number of spring, we have to continue adding. And the frequency of the oscillation, it will be equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of k equivalent by m, and the time period it will be equal to 2 pi square root of m divided by k equivalent. So in today's class we have learned the different expression for simple harmonic motion. We have derived the velocity, acceleration taking the displacement equation. We have found the expression for velocity maximum and acceleration maximum, and we have represented the displacement, velocity and the acceleration in the phasor diagram. We have derived the expression for the mechanical simple harmonic oscillator, the frequency and the time period, and also we have derived the spring constant value. Further, we have derived the equivalent spring constant in the case of series and in parallel, and we have related with the frequency and the time period equation. Thank you.